Hello everybody and welcome back to Ready, Sit, Geek. Today guys we have the HyperX SoloCast USB microphone that retails for around about £65 or $60. The link as always is in the video description below. If you're interested, I also reviewed the Quadcast S from HyperX. The link is also in the description. Design wise, and it's simple and sleek, you have a single red LED and a grey HyperX logo set on the all black finish. It's also incredibly small, standing at only 7 inches tall when it's in its stand and 3 inches wide at its widest. When it's in its stand, you can tilt the mic horizontally up to 90 degrees. It has sort of two tilts. You can tilt 45 and then 90, and it can tilt either way. I really like this aspect just because it's so simple, a quick tilt, and you can make sure the SoloCast doesn't interfere with your gaming experience. If you don't like the mount for whatever reason, you can use your own stand if you like, or maybe even a desk arm. It's very easy to remove the microphone from the mount and to put it back in. There's a built-in mute touch button on the top of the microphone, much like the Quadcast S. When you mute the mic, the LED will go from a solid red to a blinking red. Personally, I think they should have just chosen another colour rather than the blinking animation, as this can get very annoying. I'm sure by now you want to know exactly what it sounds like. Well, I am using the HyperX SoloCast right now. I'm about 20 centimetres away from the mic and I'm not using a pop filter or any kind of editing, so it gives you an idea of just how it sounds. I'm sure like me you're blown away that a $60 microphone can sound this good, but it does. I find the quality of audio to be very good, clear and crisp and perfect for streaming or voiceovers. The HyperX SoloCast does have only one recording pattern, cardioid, which makes it much less versatile than some other mics on the market. But the pattern is perfect for one-on-one recordings, and that is obviously the target demographic. There also isn't any gain control, so no ad hoc adjustments made directly from the mic itself. Along with that, there's no headphone port for monitoring either. Obviously, it is better to have these features than to not, but having said that, I do admire the simplicity of the SoloCast. It's plug and play and as simple as you can get, perfect for new streamers and content creators. Overall, and I would highly recommend the HyperX SoloCast. It's nice to see such good value for money, a well-built microphone that sounds great and looks great. If you're new to streaming or looking to add a little bit more quality to your content without breaking the bank, the bare bones SoloCast is the perfect microphone for you. The link as always is in the video description below if you want to make the purchase. Always thank you for watching Ready, Sit, Geek, and I will see you on the next video.